Hey guys, it's Kevin. So I've been switching between the Galaxy S22 Ultra and the Galaxy Z Flip 4 every other week for the past month now. My main Android phone for most of the year has been the S22 Ultra, and with Samsung's newest foldable flagships, can this replace it? In this video, I'll share the differences between each phone and which features I prefer more. These two phones are great in their own ways, and I'm not hating on any of them. This is just based on my personal use case. So let's get started. I'm going to get the price out of the way real quick. The S22 Ultra costs $1,049 for the base model at the time of this recording. The Flip 4 on the other hand costs $999. Do keep in mind that the S22 Ultra was released back in February with a launch price of $1,199. Even though the Flip 4 is cheaper by $50, the hardware and software are what set these two phones apart. If you're interested, I'll leave a link to both of these in the description box below. Both the S22 Ultra and the Flip 4 have similar displays, AMOLED, 120Hz, and Gorilla Glass Victus Plus, but you can start to see the differences when both phones are side by side. I prefer the display on the S22 Ultra. It's a bit bigger, brighter, and it's closer to an 18:9 aspect ratio. When I'm scrolling through Twitter, the text and media are a lot bigger. The Flip 4's display isn't bad, it's just a tad smaller, but maybe I'm just old. And watching videos is a different story. There's more letterboxing on the Flip 4 since it's a 22:9 aspect ratio. You can zoom in on a video to fill the whole screen, but some of the video gets cropped out. I also notice vertical videos get cropped too. Here's a TikTok video and you can see the sides get cropped. I do like that the Flip 4 shows more vertical content though. Plus when I'm scrolling, my finger rarely touches the crease. These two phones have excellent build quality. Gorilla Glass Victus Plus with an aluminum frame. I do like the Flip more because it, well, folds in half. And I'm still fascinated by the fact that glass can bend like this. Since the Flip 4 is ultra portable, I don't need to worry about falling out of my pocket when I sit down. The S22 Ultra starts to slide out as soon as I stand up. Things are different when I need to unlock the phone though. On a traditional slab phone, I pick it up, the display wakes up, use the fingerprint reader, and I'm done. On the folding phone, I pick it up, the cover display wakes up, unfold it with two hands or one-handed, and use the fingerprint reader. Sometimes I find it a hassle to open my phone every time I want to use it, but maybe I should cut on my phone usage. The Flip 4 has the newer Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1 versus the S22 Ultra Snapdragon 8 Gen 1. When I'm performing everyday activities, I honestly can't tell the difference. It's only when I have the two phones side by side and launch a game. Multitasking on both phones is buttery smooth, even though the Flip 4 has 4GB of less RAM than the S22 Ultra. For battery life, I do notice a big difference, but that's expected since the S22 Ultra has about a 1.35 times larger battery than the Flip 4, 5000mAh battery versus 3700. I don't do anything too intense on my phone, just the usual social media, watching videos, taking pictures, and recording videos. The S22 Ultra can easily last me a day and a half, while the Flip 4 can last me a day. It's not bad since I have a cable and wireless charger readily available. The cameras in both phones are pretty great. The S22 Ultra does have an edge with the higher megapixel camera, two telephoto cameras, laser autofocus, and 8K video recording. But if you're just taking pictures and posting it on social media, then the quality shouldn't matter. I like the quality more on the S22 Ultra, but I like using the camera on the Flip 4, if that makes sense. Most of the time, I won't need a tripod for the Flip 4. When I'm recording videos, it reminds me of a camcorder. Plus, if you ever need to take a selfie, I can use the cover screen with the main cameras. With the better display, design, and battery life, the S22 Ultra will continue to be my main Android phone. Again, the Galaxy Z Flip 4 is not a bad phone at all. Based on how I use the phone, I prefer the S22 Ultra. Let me know which phone you're more likely to use in the comments down below. If you enjoyed this video, then you might like to check out my review on the Galaxy S22 Ultra and the 14-inch MacBook Pro. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye!